So hello dear students, in this video I am going to continue the chapter 5 of advanced mathematics class 10. So let's see question number 7. In the previous video we have discussed the previous questions. Question number 7 is that find the value, one number is given 7.92 to the power 5. So we have to, since the chapter is logarithm, so we have to use log to find the value of 7.92 to the power 5. So first of all, we'll take it as x. Let x is equal to 7.92 to the power 5. So now take log both sides. Log of x is equal to log of 7.92 to the power 5. So we know that log of m to the power p means what? P log m. So we can log of this to the power 5 means what? 5 log 7.92. So now 5 into log of 7.92, we have to find the value of log of 7.92 from logarithmic table. So now use logarithmic table. So before that, first of all we'll assume that there is no decimal point, that means the number is 7.92. We'll divide it first of all 2 digit, 1 digit, and then if there is other digit, then we'll take it as another column. Since there is only 3 digits, the last column there will be no column number, so we'll find it row number 79 from logarithmic table. So let's see logarithmic table. We have row number 79 and column number 2. So row number 79, this one is row number 79 and column number 2, 012, that means 8987. We have the value, corresponding value is 8987. Since column number of mean difference is absent, that means 0, so there is no column number in mean difference, there is no column starting with 0, so we will have the value 0 plus 7, that will be the same value 98. So we have to put decimal point in front of that number. So we have the value log of 7.92 is 0.89 into 87. So after multiplying, we will get 5 7s are 35, carry 3, 5 8s are 14, carry 3, 43, 3 carry 4, 5 9s are 45 and carry 4, 49. Carry 4, 5 8s are 40 and 4, 44. Now see, since decimal place is after 4 digits, so we have to give decimal point here. Now we got it log of x, but we need to find the value of x here. This is the value of log x. We need to find the x means what? This number. We need to find the value of this number. This number means what? X. So we need to find value of x. If we want to find value of x, then we have to take anti-log both sides. So if we take anti-log, it will become x here, anti-log of 4.4935. so now see, anti-log of 4.4935, since this is the positive number, so this 4 is the characteristic and this is the mantissa part. So we will find the mantissa part from anti-logarithmic table. So now we will use anti-log table. It can be written as anti-log of 4 plus 0.4935. So First of all, we have to find the value of mantis from antilock table. So use antilock table. So we have row number 0.49 and column number 3 and column number 5 from mean difference. So we have 49. This is the row number 49 and we have column number 3. Column number 3 0, 1, 2, 3. That means the value is 311. So write down it 3112. Now we have to see column number 5 from mean difference column. So mean difference column, see 1 2 3 4 5, that is the corresponding value is in column number 5, corresponding value is 4. So we have to add this value 4. So what is the value? 6 1 1 3. Since decimal number is 4, characteristic is 4, that means how many digits are there in the original number? Since we get 3116 and characteristic is 4, that means there are total 5 digits before decimal number. So since there are only 4 digits we get, so we have to give 10 here, then it will become 5 digit, then we have to give decimal point. Here you can give 0, it doesn't matter if you don't give 0 also. So value of this x is this one. You may get some difference value, since in different logarithmic table the value are given in 5 digit, 4 digit, etc. So here slightly answer may be different, so it doesn't matter. Let's see question number 3 of number 7. So we have to find the value of this number. So let x is equal to 0.264 to the power 1/5. So to find the value, we have to take log both sides. Log of x is equal to log of 0.264 1/5. So here 1/5 will come in front, log. If we write it in standard form, we can write 2.64 into 10 to the power minus 1. So 1/5, this can be written as log of 2.64 plus log of 10 inverse. 1/5 log of 2.64, we have to find from mantissa log of 2.64. Here log of 10 to the minus 1 means minus 1. So now we have to find the value of log of 2.64 from mantissa, that means 26 number row and 4 number column, neglecting the decimal point. 26 number row, 4 number column and 0 number column from mean difference, since the 4th digit is absent here. So let's find. So if we see 26 number column and for 26 number row, 4 number column, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, that means the value is 4216. So we have the value 4216 and in front of it we have to give decimal and then minus 1. So after solving this one, 0.4216 is in positive, minus 1 is in negative. So after solving it, we get characteristic. So we get, after solving this thing, we get minus 0.5784. So now we have to divide it by 5. So after dividing by 5, we get the value 0.11568. So now, since this logarithm cannot be negative, so we have to, this is mantissa part which is cannot be negative, so we have to add 1 and then subtract 1 with this number. So minus 1 plus 1, then minus 0.11568. So after adding 1 and subtracting 1, then we get the value minus 1 plus 0.88432. So this minus 1 is the characteristic here and this is the mantissa part here. So we can write log of x is equal to minus 1 plus 0.88432. You can write 1 bar here, then you have to write the numbers together. So now we have to find the value of x, not log x. So if we cancel log here, then we have to take anti-log. That means x is equal to anti-log, taking anti-log both sides, minus 1 plus 0.88432. Now this minus 1 is the characteristic. Since minus 1 is the characteristic, that means this after decimal point there is no zero. So we have to find the mantissa part from the logarithmic table. That means 0.88 row, 4 number column and then 3 number column. 88 row, 4 number column and 3 number column. We have to find the corresponding value from anti-logarithmic table now. 0.88. So if you see 0.88 row, 4 number column has 7656 and in 3 number column we have 5656 and then we have 581, carry on 667. So the corresponding value of 0.88432 is 7661. So put 7661. Since characteristics is 1 here, minus 1, that means after decimal point there is no zero. That means we have to give decimal point in front of the number. So this is the value of the given number. Let's see question number 5 of 7. 3 square root of 125 into 147 by 21 into 32 square. So if we break it, we can write it 125 into 147 by 21 into 32 to the power 2 by 3. We have taken it as x. So find log of x. If we take log x in this side also, we have to take log of this number 125 into 147 21 into 32 to the power 2 by 3. So this 2 by 3 will come in front. We have to write, and here if we break it directly, you know how to break it. These are in multiplication in numerators, so we have to write log of 125 plus log of 147. These two are in denominator, so log of it will be subtracted. Log of 21 minus log of 32. Log of 32. So now see, we can break it. Log of this can be written as 5 cube plus this can be written as log of 7 square into 3, that means 49 into 3. This can be written as log of 3 into 7 and this can be written as log of 2 to the power 5. You can directly find the value from the logarithmic table, but it will be easier for you. So 2 by 3 will remain same. Here we can write 3 log of 5. Here I am writing directly. Here we can write 2 log 7 plus 2 log of 7, then plus log of 3. Here minus is there, minus log of 3, then minus log of 7. And here minus 5 log 2. So 2/3, 3 log, we have here 3 log 5. Here see, 2 log 7 and -log 7, we have 1 log 7, that means log of 7, log 3 and log 3 cancel, and then -5 log 2. Now we have to put this value. 3 log 5, value of log 5 is 3 into value of log 5 is 0.6989 plus log of 7 means 0.8451, and minus 5 into log of 3, you know, log of 2, you know, 0.30103, you can write, or as you wish. So after solving this, we get these values, and now add these two and subtract this one. So we will get 1.4367. So now we have to multiply by 2 and then divide by 2. So after multiplying by 2 and dividing by 2, I have got the value 0.9578. So this is the value of log of x. This is nothing but the value of log of x. So we need the value of x, so we have to take anti-log both sides. Now we have to take anti-log both sides, and if we take anti-log, here we will get x, here anti-log of 0.9578. here characteristic is 0, that means before decimal point only one digit is there, so that 1 minus 1 is 0. So now we have to find the value of 0.95 row, 5 number column and then 7 number column. The corresponding value we have to get from the logarithmic anti-log table. So the corresponding value of 0.95 row and 5 number column is this one, and in the mean difference 7 number column is 17. So after adding, we get 9074. Now since characteristic is 0, then where is the decimal place? Decimal place is after one digit from left side. So this is the value.